Grade 11 Essential Interest and Credit Part 6. The Rule of 72 and Personal Loans. So pause this anytime you want, rewind, whatever, it's a movie. Let's do the quick warm-up review of last lessons there. Quick warm-up of simple interest. All right, get out your calculator, calculate those. When you're ready, come on back. Here I go. So you write down the formula, I equals P times R times T. Write down the formula. Plug in the numbers. This one's pretty easy. This is just a straight plug in and hit your equals button. Just be careful though, because half a year is half a year. Well, that's right. Okay, the trick comes in this one. All right, so you plug in the numbers. Now, whether you do it as fraction, I prefer fractions myself, because then you can actually do it without a calculator. But if you insist on using decimals, then you could have done it this way as well, but then you kind of need a calculator, that way. Let's do the second one right here. It's a straight plug-in, and hit equals on your calculator. I like doing it without a calculator. Don't forget, when you put in your time, you don't put in 4. You don't put in 4 because the formula needs time in years. So you cannot put in 4. You put in 4/12 because 4/12 of a month of a year is 4 months. So don't forget in the formula, this is in years. And then when you add your interest that you earned, the $4. So you had $400. You earned $3 for every 100 per year for a third of a year. So you really earn $4 in interest plus the $400 you started with. So you get back $404. It's free money. What the heck? Now we got to do a little bit of working backwards. I hesitate to use the word algebra. So you write down the formula. Then you plug in the numbers. Notice this time we got numbers on the left of the equal sign as well. Notice we have an unknown amount, the rate. So you still write it down. You want to find out what it is. So you still write down the symbol R for the sum amount of interest. It's sum amount of interest. Notice that any time you have an equation with a whole bunch of stuff and some unknown amount, all you got to do is juggle the numbers to the other side to get the sum amount by itself. So I like to tidy up the numbers. 2,000 times 4 is 8,000. Pop it under the 100, and boom, now the R is by itself. So that's the same as 1 over 80, which is 0.0125, which is 1.25%. And that's kind of like what you would get today at a bank. All right, so if you have 2,000 and you earn an extra 100, you now have a total amount of 2,100. Let's do the next one. Turns out the answer is 8 years. Let's do the math. I equals write down the formula, plug in the numbers, and if you got a symbol, one symbol left over, it's real easy because you just move all the other numbers to the other side. Tidy up these numbers. These are like terms, a number and a number. Why don't you combine them? 1,000 times 0.05 is 50. Can you do that in your head? And you pop the 50 under the 400, and it tells you the time is 400 divided by 50. Sounds like about 8 years to meet. Right? That's a 50 there, isn't it? So it's 8 years. So I better fix this up. This is actually a 50. Not a 5. So it ends up being 8 years. So 8 years, 5%, $1,000, 400 interest. You now have what? What am I saying? You now have 1,400. Oh my goodness. All right. Not 4,100. That's kind of silly. All right. Next slide. Sorry about that. Next slide. Dyslexic or what? All right. How about if Joanne invests $400 in a GIC that pays 8% APR, that's annual percentage rate, for 9 years? It's compounded annually, right? The word annual is like anniversary, so that's one time per year. What is the total amount? How much interest had she earned? All right, so this is a compound interest. So this is all still review, so you write down the formula. Then you plug in the numbers. Then you hit the equals button on your calculator. Compound interest is usually actually pretty easy. And it's kind of fun, too. So I get $799.60 using the formula. How much interest had she earned? Well, if she started with 400 and she earned $799.60, sounds like she earned an extra $399.60. So that's the interest that she earned. And of course, remember that rule of 72? Well, we haven't learned it yet, but it turns out that if the interest rate times the number of years is equal to 72, then you'll pretty much double your money. Notice that 400 doubled up is 800. Turns out we'll learn that rule next. How about if she'd only had simple interest instead? Remember, with compound, she earned about $800. Well, if it was only simple interest, can you do this without a calculator? She would have only earned 288 instead of 399.60. So just remember that compound interest always pays more. Compound interest pays off better. For a short time, they're pretty much the same thing. Let's try Dave here. I'll just accelerate this. Make sure you know how to use your exponent button. And that's what it looks like on a good calculator. Make sure you have a good calculator that has a multi-line display that shows every number and operation you typed into your calculator. If all you got is a dollarama calculator, that would be kind of hazardous. There's a good chance you might miss something and you would never know that you missed something. So how much interest had he earned? All right, so there's that. So that was the review. Let's check out this rule of 72. The rule of 72, well, you can read this, pause. So the rule of 72 pretty much says if you take your interest rate and multiply it by the number of years, if that equals 72, then you doubled your money. So it's just a handy way to do a little bit of mental math if you want to know how long it takes to double your money or what interest rate you need to double your money. This is page 7 in your notes, of course. So if the rate times the time equals 72, then you double your money. And don't forget, sometimes we call the time of your loan, of your investment rather, sometimes we call the time T, and sometimes we call it N in the compound interest formula. So just be aware that we interchange the N and T sometimes. So just be familiar with the... It doesn't matter what symbol you use to represent the idea. All right, so what if you had these... what if you had an interest rate of 8? 8 times what is 72? 8 times. So we're trying to find out what number would give you 72. So 8 times what is 72? Well, sounds like that 72 divided by 8 is 9. So in 9 years, you would double your money at 8% interest. 6 times 12 is 72. So to double your money at 6% takes 12 years. 36 times 2, right? So 2 times what is 72? Well, 36. So if you only have 2% interest, kind of what we have recently, the last decade, then it takes 36 years to double your money. What times 9 is 72? So what interest rate would you need if you put your money away for 9 years, say you're going to retire, and you want it to double in 9 years? Well, you would need to get 8% at the bank. You would have a hard time doing that at a bank. Not these days. Next slide. So this is from the notes. All right, you can pause this anytime you want. Okay, so there, try this. Pause it, and let's see what numbers you come up with. All right, are you done? Here we go. Six times what is 72? 12. Now, you can check it too if you don't believe it works. I actually had you check it, but I had you check it for $1. It's a lot easier to work with $1 and see if it doubles than it is to work with $1,000. It's just less numbers to type into the calculator. So let's see what happens if we take a principal of 1 and invest it at 6% for 12 years. And look at that. It works out that it's 2. So you turn $1 into $2.01. So that's pretty much a doubling. All right. So, and we're just calculating this with a, we're just assuming it's all annual interest. Remember how compound interest, whether it's annual or quarterly, doesn't make a big difference. How about if we invest at 12% for 6 years? Because in theory, 12% for 6 years should double our money. Well, let's try it. Let's take a dollar and invest it. And we'll invest it at 12% for 6 years. And let's see what the plastic brain tells us. We get 1.12 raised to the 6, which ends up being $1.97. So we can turn $1 into $1.97 if we invested at 12% for 6 years. So it's pretty much a doubling. Your $1 doubled. And we just tested the formula, and usually if you test something and it works lots and lots of times, you can have a lot of faith in a formula. If it works lots of times, usually you can have some faith in it. How about if we had 15 years, say we're going to retire in 15 years and we want to double our money. 15 times what is 72? Well, it turns out that 72 divided by 15 is 4.8. So if you put your money in the bank at 15, for 15 years, if you get 4.8% interest, then that should double it. Let's try it with $1 and see if we double $1. And if you do all that annual compounding, you end up with 1.048 raised to the 15. Use your exponent button, you get 2.02. So we took $1 and we doubled it pretty much. Little hair more than double. So it looks like the rule works. So the rule of 72 is just the handy way to do a little bit of quick calculation in your head. Next slide. Personal loans. Read this. Pause if you want. Read it. Let's go. All right, so you could use a formula for this. Check out this fancy formula. Oh my goodness, you do not want to be putting that formula into a calculator. There's a really good chance that you'll mess that up. But there is a formula for it. Try it if you want. I've done it before and it works. Normally we use tables of values. All right. Normally what we do is we do some pre-computed. We've already solved it a whole bunch of times for different situations. So what we do is we do tables of values. We kind of like pre-compute a whole bunch of different scenarios. So there's an example of the tables. All right. So there's some tables right there. And I've issued you several forms of this in nice colored paper for the front of your binder. So the way you read these tables is you come down the side here. That's the annual rate that you're going to pay on your loan. And then you come across to the number of years you're going to take your loan. And that's how much money you pay per thousand of your loan. All right, so check out the example I give you here. There's someone borrowing $10,000 for 5 years at 6%. So they're going to pay $19.34 a month. Well, that's for every thousand. So, of course, if it's $19.34 a month for every thousand and they borrowed $10,000, doesn't that mean they're going to pay $193.40 a month? So you got to multiply that number by 10 because they borrowed $10,000. So, of course, they're going to pay 5 years. So they're going to make 5 years of payments, which of course is going to be 60 payments. Let's try an example here. Let's try the calculation for a loan of $75,000 at 8% interest over 20-year amortization, or term they call it. So you should get $627.33 for the monthly payment. Pause, try it. So you use the tables, of course, and when I look it up on the tables, it looks like this. Under the 20, adjacent to the 8, I get $8.30. So my payments are going to be $8.36 a month, but that's for every thousand. So I'm going to have to multiply that by what? 75. I got to figure out how many thousands 75,000 is. I think it's 75. So this will be your total monthly payment for your $75,000 loan. So you're going to pay $627 every month, and you're going to do that for 20 years. Now, would you believe that 20 years is really 240 months? So if you're working in months, you got to calculate months here. So you're going to end up paying, after 20 years of payments, you'll pay $150,480 for your $75,000 loan. And that's about right. If you drag out something at a pretty high interest rate for a long time, it's going to pretty much cost you double what you want. But of course, you're getting the thing 20 years before you would normally get it, right? So if you want to get something now, instead of waiting 20 years and saving the money, it's going to cost you bucks. Okay, pause. Let's try a more realistic calculation, like $300,000 for a house at a more realistic interest rate you get these days of 5%, and most people pay for their house over 25 years. And if you look it up in the tables, let's see, 5%, 25 years, I did an extract of the table, looks like about $5.85, so you're going to pay $5.85 a month for every thousand. So you're going to have to multiply that by how many thousands is 300,000. So it's $5.85 for every thousand. It's not $5.85 a month. So you got to multiply it by, well, isn't it going to be 300? Isn't 300,000 just 300 thousands? So your monthly payments are going to be that. $1,755 every month. So that's kind of steep. But if you're a couple, then you know you could, you know, if you got a, if you're a couple, a working couple, and you got two jobs each, you could probably afford that. Don't lose your job though. All right, so how much do you pay in total? Well, if you pay $1,755 every month for 25 years, aren't there 12 months in 1 year? So notice how the units cancel out like we did in grade 10. So you got to go 1755 times 25 times 12. You're going to end up paying $526,000. $526,500 for your $300,000 house, but you're getting it 25 years earlier. So, how much interest did you pay? Well, if you pay $526,500 to get $300,000, that you do some subtracting to find the difference. So you paid interest of $226,500 interest to get your $300,000 loan. All right, pause and read this. So this was your assignment. All right, did you pause? Did you read it? So in reality, what happens is when you borrow money, you can't just borrow money and say, oh, I'll be back in 5 years with your money. It doesn't work that way. Banks, when they loan you money, that might work with your uncle, but banks, when they loan you money, they want to see you pay it back monthly. And that's good for two reasons. First of all, it's good for the bank because then they know you're still in town and you haven't taken off. And secondly, it's good for you because you're actually nibbling away and you actually pay less interest by paying it off every month instead of waiting till the very end of the loan when you get this huge amount that you have to pay. So personal loans, you generally end up paying every month as you whittle down the loan. So let's do an example here. Okay, read this. Pause. Okay, so you borrow $6,500 from the bank at 9%, and you want to pay it off. You want to amortize it, the word mort. In French means to kill, so you want to kill off your loan after 5 years. What will your monthly payments be? Well, you got to look it up in the tables. All right, if you look it up in the tables, 5 years for 9%, and you look it up in the tables, it says $20.76 for every 1,000. So your monthly payments are going to be $20.76 for every 1,000. So, of course, we're going to multiply that by how many thousands you made. So you borrowed $6,500. That sounds like about 6,500. So your monthly payments are $134.94. How many monthly payments will you have? Well, let's see. 5 years is the same as, I think there's 12 months in a year. I think 5 years is pretty much 60 months. 12 months per year, that's 60 months. So you got to make 60 payments, one every month. So how much do you pay? Well, if you're paying $134.94 every month for 60 months, let's multiply those two numbers together. And notice how keeping track of the units like we did in grade 10 is a handy way to make sure that your numbers are going to work out. If the units work out, then the numbers will work out. What was your cost to borrow the money? Well, let's see. You borrowed $6,500. You paid $8,096 for it. So you want to find a difference. You want to subtract. So it cost you interest of $1,596.40 to borrow $6,500 over 5 years. And if you join me in applied math, you'll use this fancy app. There's all kinds of apps on the internet and on computers and on your iPhone. Or you could go to a website. Here's the Bank of Montreal. The Bank of Montreal has, every bank has a loan calculator. Notice when we did our calculation, it said 134.94, and the computer at the Bank of Montreal says 134.93. Well, that's because I rounded my numbers in the table, right? So I had to give you some numbers that didn't go on and on forever. So when I prepared the tables for you, I had rounded the numbers. So don't expect to get a... They might be off by a penny when you do the calculations. All right, let's do another calculation here. You borrow $15,000 from the bank at 6% interest, and you want to pay it off. You want to amortize it. You want to kill it off after 10 years. So you look it up in the tables. The tables tell you it's $11.10 per month per thousand. And it's going to be 15 thousands. So it's going to be $166.50 every month is your monthly payment. So how many monthly payments do you make? Well, it seems to me that 10 years is really the same as 120 months. 10 times 12 is 120. So you're going to have 120 of those. So 120 of those added together is what we call 120 times 166.50. Make sure the units cancel out. Then you know that you got the formula right. So you're going to pay $19,980 for your $15,000 loan. What was your cost to borrow that money? In other words, what was the interest? All right, so if you paid $19,980 minus the $15,000, sounds like it cost you $4,980. How much would the loan have cost if you'd paid it off in 5 years instead? So now look it up on the tables again. And you'll see it tells you that it's $19.33. So if you pay it off in 5 years instead of 10 years, notice that your payments are more, but it'll be for less time. So it turns out that if you can pay off a loan quicker, it's way better. Don't drag out a loan. So your payments are going to be $289.95 a month times the 60 months now, because it's only for 5 years. So you're going to pay $17,397 total, right? When you did it for 10 years, you paid $19,980 for your $15,000. If you do it for 5 years and really, really pay it off quickly, then it's only going to cost you $2,397 for the loan. So you save a lot of money by paying it off quickly. If you pay it off for 10 years, it's going to cost you that amount of interest. If you pay it off in 5 years, it's going to cost that amount of interest. So try to pay off the loan as quickly as possible. What if you drag it out for 25 years? You got to look it up in the tables again. Notice the number changes. Anytime you change the amortization period or the rate, you got to look it up in the tables again. If you drag it out for 25 years, it's going to cost you more. So if you drag it out for 25 years, it's going to end up costing you $13,980 interest to pay for your $15,000 loan. So it pretty much doubles what you borrow. So the secret there is, anytime you got a loan, pay it off as quickly as possible. Eat crab dinner for 5 years if you have to. Do not drag out the time you pay off a loan. Let's try this one. You borrow $250,000 from the bank for a loan at 8.5% interest, and you want to pay it off after 10 years. And you look in the table and you go, but I don't know what the interest rate is for 8.5. I know that 8 is 12.13, and I know that 9 is $12.67. Well, gee, what do you think 8.5 is? Wouldn't it be halfway? How do you find halfway? If you add them together and divide by 2, wouldn't that be halfway? So you would use 1240, because 1240 is exactly halfway between those, right? It's 27 cents more than that, and it's 27 cents less than that. So 1240 is your rate. It's called interpolating. We did some interpolating in grade 10. So interpolating is figuring out numbers between other numbers. So your payments are going to be $3,100 a month. That's a lot of money. But if you got two jobs and your partner has a job or two, and, you know, maybe somebody helped you out with a loan, you could do that. How many monthly payments do you make? Well, it's 10 years, 120 months if you go for 10 years. How much will you have paid at the end of the loan? Well, didn't we say it was $3,100 a month times 120 months is going to give you $372,000. So how much did you pay to borrow? In other words, what was your interest? You paid $372,000 to get $250,000. So it cost you $122,000 in interest for your house. Now, what would happen if you'd have crashed this program and you paid it off in 5 years instead? All right, I had a friend that did that. He ate Kraft dinner, he didn't drink, he didn't smoke, he didn't even have a girlfriend, but he paid off his house in 5 years. He worked overtime, and he paid off his house. It saved him hundreds of thousands of dollars. So you go back to the table, all right, 8.5%, let's find the halfway point, add them together, or halfway is going to be $20.52. $20.52 every month for every thousand. All right, how many thousands did he borrow? Let's see, 250,000 divided by 1,000, that would be 250,000s. Goodness. All right, if you show the units, you can't possibly go wrong. Times 60 months for... Okay, so it turns out that you're going to end up with... What are your payments? All right, so multiply those all together, you end up with $307,000. So you only pay, you borrowed $250,000, so you only pay $57,800 in interest. That's way better than the other two scenarios. So the quicker you can pay off a loan, the better. So we only paid $57,800 in interest. By the way, if you did that calculation for these two numbers here, your payments are $5,130 a month, which pretty much means you'll be living off Kraft dinner and stuff, and chances are the bank won't loan you that much money. You'd probably want to get somebody to co-sign on your loan or something. It gets a little more complicated when you stretch yourself thin like that. But you do save a lot of money, right? By paying it off in... By paying it off in 5 years, it's going to cost you $58,000 in interest, whereas if you went for 25 years, like most people do, it would have cost you $122,000 in interest. So you saved yourself, $60,000 or so by paying it off as quickly as you can. $60,000, that's a few bucks. Next slide. So there's your summary. Rule of 72. If your interest rate times your time, in years, is equal to 72, then you doubled your money. Personal loans have monthly payments. The bank wants to make sure you're still in town. And that's actually good, having monthly payments, because then you whittle down what you owe right from the very beginning, so you start right away making payments. And to find the how to calculate them, you look it up in the monthly payment tables. And the numbers we give you are how much it's going to cost you per month per thousand. And then you take that number in the tables, which is a monthly amount, and you multiply it by the number of thousands. And times the time that you have the loan. So that was a quick summary of how we calculate personal loans and how we do the rule of 72. Complete.